Sin mayor. Rei is in the singular. Lifneichem is in the plural. You individually should say, I'm putting before all of you, Hayom Brachu. So, which is what is the Brachu Klo we're speaking about? Hamuros, Bahagrisim, Bahrevel. The Brachu from the two mountains. No, he's just referring to which bracha and klala. So here there's a balaturim. The balaturim says rei anochi, oma b'loshen yochid. Right, rei is singular. Perusha rei oma l'kol echad v'echod. In terms of how each one processes something, we process it in our own unique way. But before who is being presented? Lifneichem. Right, we all saw. We all stood on Hagriz Marevo, we heard the brochs and the klolos. But how does each one process it? We process it as individuals. Everyone has his own grasp and a take on whatever something may be. So that's singular. That's why it's singular, and then we speak in the plural. So it's interesting, when two people taste the same thing, does it taste identically the same? We have no idea. Two people could identify something, maybe the same thing, because there's enough, each of them tastes it in a way which we relate to it, it's the same thing. But the personal experience of taste, that one's taste buds, two people's taste buds are necessarily the same. We have no idea. And anything we experience, there's something which is unique to each person, he experiences on a personal level. You're attributing to Israel, that statement was said before the State of Israel. Okay. Rabbi Yaakov Kamenetz, the Tzadik Lebrocha, once said that Yisrael Tzar Bali Chaim, you're not permitted to bring undue pain to an animal. So you have people who are the animal activists. They're concerned for the abuse of animals. So if you have a donkey, and you... it's a beast of burden. So man has been abusing the donkey for thousands of years. What made it was man chose to make it a beast of burden. But it's, would you have a right to burden the donkey? Would you want to be put that kind of load on you? Right? So Yaakov said something interesting. He says, people, they try to equate the way a human being experiences something the way an animal experiences something. We have no idea the way an animal experiences. When you put a burden on the donkey, it may thrive in that state. Of course, you could abuse it. You could overdo it. You see an animal's faltering under the load the Torah speaks about. So then you have to unload it. But up to a certain capacity, that's not called abusing the animal. Would you want to be treated in that way? How could you compare two things, one species to it's a different species? It even has to do with cultures. The way people deal with different people in different cultures in terms of disciplining them based on the culture, and one would be considered abuse, and one, there's no other way to deal with them other than what? Other than that particular way. That's not called abusing them. Because unless you discipline them a certain way, they're not disciplined because of the culture they come from. That's a reality. So Ray, taking it to a more sophisticated level, in terms of how one processes spirituality, and the liabilities and the consequences, and the ups and the downs of whatever the value is, each person processes it differently. How should I speak? Es a brocha shetishmu. What is this? Is the brocha ashetishmu el mitzvos Hashem avokechem asher anochi mitzav eschem yom. That's the brocha. We're not even talking about the reward. That you have the capacity. I think the Orachaim HaKadosh explains this way. The brocha is ashetishmu el mitzvos Hashem avokechem. That you have the capacity to listen to the mitzvos Hashem avokechem asher anochi mitzav eschem yom. That's the brocha. You know, brocha is a person behaves properly, that's brocha. As you say, you get it. We're not even talking about what the reward's going to be and what the value is. The brocha is that you understand it and you internalize it as it should be internalized. That's a brocha. Person doesn't get it, that's a klola. That's just explained. Ashetishma. The listening itself is the brocha. We're not even going beyond that point. No, that's what it is. Listen doesn't mean the sense of hearing. It means listening means appreciating it, to understand it, to see its value. Tishmu is to see its value. That is bracha, to be able to see the value of something which has true value. And to see something which you should flee from, to see its detriment to you. There's a haklola, asher lo sishmu. What is klola? Asher lo sishmu mitzvos Hashem Elokecha. There's no Chazonish, he wrote letters, and his letters called Igros Chazonish. He writes over there that the greatest pain in his life was when he failed, spiritually speaking. When he was chote at his level. That was the greatest tsar that he had in his life, the greatest pain. There was no greater pain in his life. That he did at his level, whatever that failing was. That's haklola. Klola, what im lo sishmu? Al mitzvah Hashem Elokechem, sarta miradech, and you veer from the path, asher nochi mitzav eschem hayom, leches achrei elohim acherim asher lo yedatim. Go after false gods that you don't know. The Rosh Hashiva of Rabin, the Chofetz Chaim was in the Rosh Hashiva. Even though he established the Yeshiva, the Chofetz Chaim Rabin, but the Rosh Hashiva's name was Rabbi Naftali Trupp, T-R-O-P, Trupp. That was his name. He was a student of the Talmud of the Alta of Slabotka. He was a Slabotka student originally from Slabotka. And at that time, the Mashgiach was Rabbi Yeruchim. Rabbi Yeruchim left Rabin to go to the Mir. He was in Radin before he went to the Mir, Rabbi Yeruchim. And the Chofetz Chaim, every night, he would go up to the attic and he would say vidui, confess his sins for the day, for the end of the day. And they would walk, and he would go to the attic, and there were a few steps. And they would stand on these steps just to hear exactly how he would reprimand himself. And he would speak to himself in a way that you couldn't believe, the way he lambasted himself, the way he degraded himself, and the way he spoke about how he failed and how he didn't, you know. And the way they were amazed, they couldn't believe. We're talking about the things which another person would consider, wouldn't even notice to be a failing. And so again, so what's broke, what's clover? You know, the person, they say, well, it's a microscopic cancerous cell. Big deal. If you don't see it under the microscope, well, you can worry about it. You understand. But if you understand what that could develop into, then you understand, then you have to worry about it. The question is, what's one's capacity and sensitivity to be able to relate and understand what exactly klola is and what broch is? You speak to people. You ask them, do you put on film every? Once in a while, I miss. You know? Once you miss, in order means not to put on tefillin. It's not the end. What can I do, Rabbi? It's not the end of the world. Okay, based on where he's at, it's not the end of the world. But if he would only understand the damage and the level of failing to his spirituality, not putting on tefillin once in a lifetime, he'd understand what that is. But again, everybody's based on his own sensitivity, his own capacity of how spirituality. That.
saying, Rig.
There are many things, you know, somebody wants to hear a story that mistakenly he drank milk that was a holy soil. Was the Chol Yisrael, and when he drank it immediately afterwards, he caused that he was so upset that it happened, he caused himself to regurgitate, to just get it out of the system. He didn't want it in the system. So somebody, this written after he passed away, so somebody shared it with a certain member of his family, and the person says, it's not true. It's not true. Certain members, it's true in the other, but you understand, the correct question is, who's credible? Who's more credible regarding telling over the stories? And this person who said it wasn't true wasn't credible in many things that he said about Rav Moshe. I'm not going to say who he was, who he is. I'm going to say, you know what I mean? If you understood Rav Moshe, who Rav Moshe Feinstein was, you know, the story is not far-fetched, and you can understand the reality in terms of his capacity and sensitivity of what it means to drink milk that's not Chol Yisrael. Although he has leniencies and Rav Moshe has the United States, so on and so forth, whatever it is, doesn't make a difference. To be continued.